All right, friends, it's time for Fire Tweets. And today I'm joined by comedian Jenna Friedman, host of Adult Swim's Soft Focus with Jenna Friedman. Hello.
Hi.
Hi. I'm good. So during the break, you said something that I love. I was like, I'm sorry we're here during President's Day. I kind of wish I had the day off, but you made a good point.
Yeah, I think it's an act of protest to be here, not acknowledging that we have a president, because we don't.
Look. Fire, okay? Executive time, not around here. You basically ready to do the fire tweet situation?
Yeah, I'm though? Ready.
Okay, I'm going to do ready. The first one. I'm excited about it. Here we go. Tyler Mead, you tweeted, just because I'm attracted to men doesn't mean I have to like them. Thank you for that. Mood, do you agree?
I love men. You guys are in so much pain right now. You're hurting, and I just want us to all be a little kinder to men.
I know. It's really hard. It's been really hard for me.
I understand.
As a man, it's just I don't know what to say. Mm-hmm. I feel like anytime I talk, I'm gonna get in trouble.
Oh. Yeah, men are scary, yeah. And then they get upset and they just kill everyone.
Yeah,
so I think we need to
thing.
Be kinder.
Yeah, very sweet. Have you said something nice to a man today, America?
Man, okay. Today is National Man Day.
Oh, God.
And we need to thank men so that they don't kill us.
Oh, my God. Don't kill us, please. Okay, you ready to do this fire tweet?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you hit the button. It's all you, girl.
Oh.
There we go.
Oh, Joel Kim Booster has a really, really funny tweet. Starting in August, we should begin sending one Democratic presidential candidate home every week until we've narrowed it down to a top four who are allowed to campaign in earnest midway through all the eliminated girls come back for a chance to re-enter the competition. So, such a good use of the 240-word character limit.
Joel went all the way in on
Joel's
that.
Joel's a very funny comedian.
I love Joel.
I do think we could bachelor the Democratic
You know, I wouldn't.
Race.
The primary, we might need to, like, bachelor / RuPaul's Drag Race the Democratic primary. It's a lot. I see you do. You, of course, don't shy away from politics. Have you always been tweeting about politics, or is it something like in the last few years?
Since before Twitter even started.
Okay. You were tweeting.
About politics. Yeah, I had no followers, but, you know.
Yeah. Is it fun? Do you enjoy it? Is it like a...
I mean, it's more of like, I can't help it. Mm-hmm. And, I mean, I don't enjoy it because we do get trolled. Like, if I say maybe Bernie should run as a Republican, which I think would be really helpful for all of us, because if he's going to win, it would be nice to knock Donald Trump out of the primaries, mm-hmm. and then we could have Bernie versus a Democratic candidate. And then really, I would be open to that healthy discussion, you know, socialism versus Democrat, whatever. But I would get trolled if I tweeted that.
The Bernie bros do have opinions, I've heard.
And that term, I'm so beaten down. But that term is now problematic because it erases all of the Russian bots who pretend to not be men on Twitter. Anyway.
Don't erase the bots. Okay, screw me. Let's get to another fire tweet because I could just talk about that for 20 minutes. This tweet comes from Bonnie McFarland. I wish my husband knew me the way Instagram ads do. Oh,
that's
this is
real.
True. There's a pair of shoes that Instagram's been trying to get me into. But let's get into the next tweet of the day. Are you ready?
Sure, yeah.
Yeah? I think we hit this together, right?
Is that what? Oh.
Yeah, you'll read this one.
Look, anytime you get anything on Twitter that's like not a death threat or calling you fat, it is a compliment.
Okay.
That's all that was about.
So being called a Russian asset is not
Thank
that bad.
Thank you. Yes, still got it.
Still got it. I mean, like, let's talk about Soft Focus because I love you. Your show on Adult Swim, like, you're talking about politics in the news with a focus on women's issue, whether it's, you know, campus rape or just sexism in politics in more general. What is it like being able to talk about this in comedy now, like having the floor?
I mean, is the Adult Swim depth? No, it's great. I mean, I think people are into talking about it in a way that they weren't before. Mm. And you can be a little bit edgier because it's like our last generation we have.
Real.
Yeah. So people
the clock
are like,
is ticking.
Okay. You know, but it's also scary. It's like, you know, there's a lot of sensitivity. So it's always a fine line. And sometimes you cross it, hopefully not. Mm-hmm. But it's always a little bit of a dance.
Right. Yeah. I wonder, I mean, like talking about rape, period, you know, requires a lot of nuance and thoughtfulness if you're going to do it. And then to try to make it funny seems like a challenge.
Well, it's happening. Mm-hmm. And if you're not a rapist, you know, like, you can make it funny if you're actually talking about it from, like, the point of view of somebody who's not a rapist.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like, so many comics are like, I can't do rape jokes. Not if they make you sound like a rapist.
Right. Yeah, it's like, is that a problem for you?
Or people,
you?
I mean, some demos might like it, but mainstream, hopefully, now is turning against rape. And really,
are y'all? I hope so, everyone. I also wanted to ask you, you know, you used to, you know, write for The Daily Show, The Late Show with David Letterman, and now, you know, you are on screen, you know, hosting your own show. What's a delightful surprise in terms of switching from being behind the scenes as a writer to being on camera?
I mean, it's nice to have, like, ownership over the things that you're doing a little bit more, and you're writing for yourself. Right. So kind of having, and Adulting's really cool because they give us a lot of creative control. So that, I would say, is the coolest thing.
I'm into it. Well, Jenna Freeman, thank you so much for joining
us
this
morning.
Thanks for having me. I love it. She is a Russian asset. I love it. Screaming. Yeah. You guys can catch the latest episodes of Soft Focus with Jenna Freeman on Adult Swim. Thanks again,
Jenna.
Thank you.
People are going to be like, you're a Russian asset.